Morning, Kumlenen, a black tomorrow. It's Erev Shabbos, Kedush, Parshas Zohar. And we are up to the Gemara Dav Chav Gimel Amud Aleph. We had an argument between Rabbah and Rava regarding two arguments, but they're both predicated on each other. One is whether a simon in public where people walk, do we say that it still maintains its siman, or do we say that there's no siman anymore because people trample on it and it either alters the siman, like some rishonim say, or the siman is gone, or actually maybe the siman not even gone, but the person, the owner, abandons hope of retrieving it because he thinks the siman is gone. And the second thing is whether makom, whether place, is a siman. If you say where it was, an argument we had with rishonim, whether you announce the place and then the person says what he lost there, or you announce the object that you found and the person says where you found it. And makom really generally only works in a public, in a private place, because people don't push around. In a public place, it gets pushed around, unless it's a very big and bulky item. So now the Gemara is going to say that perhaps this is an argument between Tanoim, and what other value will we put in? That in the Rosh Hashanah, why private loaves of bread, bread of a private person, is considered a simon, l'chayde, according to Rabbah, that a simon in a public place is not a simon, is because he says people don't walk, step on food, because they don't even walk near it, because if you walk too close, you have to pick it up and bring it back and find the owner. So therefore, food is an exception. The Gemara, Lema, where the Gemara is about 15 or 16 lines on the top of the page, the last word of the line is Lema. Lema, let us take it tonight. Actually, this is an argument tonight in our very Mishnah. Because our Mishnah is not clear. What is the argument between the first part of the Mishnah and Rabbi Yehuda? The Tana Kama, or Rabbi Meir, the first part of the Mishnah basically says all these items you can keep because there's no simon. Come to Rabbi Yehuda and says that a keli, if you found something that has a simon, and for example, a loaf of bread with a piece of clay inside, or a piece of some money inside, so a cake, sorry, a pressed cake, you know, a cake of figs with a piece of clay inside, or a loaf of bread with money inside, you have to give it back. Is it Tanakh or Tanakh Kama argue? What exactly is the crux of their argument? The Gemara wants to say that Lema, let us say, Kitanah, that in fact is the argument in our Mishnah. Rabbi Yehuda says, Kol Dovah Sheyed B'Shinah, anything that has something abnormal inside, it's Chayv L'Hachad, you have to announce it. Case of, for example, Motza Eagle of a Torah Chedis. So we're going to learn that the argument of Rabbi Rabbah, which lived yesterday, we're trying to say that's exactly the machlek is the Mishnah between Rabbi Meir and Rabbi Yehuda, who was wondering what they're arguing. Rabbi Yehuda said, you found a loaf of bread with money inside, you have to give back to the simon. And Rabbi Meir doesn't hold that. So perhaps that's the argument. Kikir, the first one is Kikir of a Torah Mois, and there's money there. McLeod Tanakham, so Rabbi Tanakham hold, Rabbi Meir hold, the Elish Light. They belong to you. What's going on here? Why would a Tanakama hold a loaf of bread with money inside? It's not a simon. So Maruah, we thought as follows. Kuli Alo, everyone agrees that simon habom me'elam have a simon. A simon that comes from itself is not really a simon. So according to the Tosfos, it means it's like it fell inside, but you knew about it and you decided to leave it there. According to Rashi, you actually put it there, and you put it there for the sake of a simon. But the point is that a person finding it doesn't really know whether it was put there for the sake of a simon or it just happened to fall in there. And that's why there's an argument, a simon that could fall in by itself, is how Rashi learns. So number one is everyone knows that's a valid simon. And umavir and alayisim. But food is no different than anything else. People would walk on top of food. So though if you hold that a simon in a public place is not a simon, neither is it by food either. And so we're talking about food, bread with money inside, cake of figs. My love, the simon, they're arguing about a simon that people trample on. This is the machlekes of Rabbah and Rava. Masava, one of them holds that they have a simon, that the Rameyah says it's not a simon, because like the Rabbah, that the simon in a public place where people tread on is not a simon. Masava, have a simon, hold it is a simon. That's the argument. So obviously, neither Rabbah nor Rabbah are happy with that, because Rabbah would like to learn that everyone agrees that simon that people trample on is not a simon, and Rabbah would like to learn that everyone holding a simon you trample on is a valid simon. So each one is going to learn the Mishnah, the argument between Rameh and Rabbi Yehuda differently. If you talk to believe, because some of the time Rameh holds that simon also does love a simon, that a simon you trample on is not a simon, that's why he holds that bread with coin is not a simon. Even though it's bread, people walk on it, so they will trample on the story of the simon. I'll ask you a question then. The next Mishnah says that Kikr Shabalabai, the loaves of bread, the loaves of bread of a balabais in a public place, nevertheless, because it's loaves of bread and it's very, you can identify it, you have to announce it. Why you have to announce it? If there's an opinion in our Mishnah that says that simonim in the public place, it gets destroyed and food people tread on, trample on. So why Kikr Shabalabais is no different than a bread with a coin in it? People will break it. There should be at least one opinion that says not a simon. And my machi is Elam Razir. I can't be an argument. It must be something else. The Kuliyama, I'll tell you, everyone hold. Obviously, it's Rabbah. So Rabbah is going to say everybody agrees to him, which is that a simon in the pub and people trample on is still a valid simon. Simon also the have a simon, it's a valid simon. And Umavi and let people walk on food, but we don't care because of a simon that you trample on is a valid simon. No, boss. So if it's a valid simon, so and that's why we understand the loaf of bread of a balabais is a simon, even a public place, it's a good simon. So why does a mayor and a Yehuda argue about a loaf of bread with a coin inside? Because this is a unique simon. It's a simon that could have fallen on its own, or a simon that did fall in on its own. You didn't make this simon happen.
So how does Rav mind to the balabais, which was serving?
Oh, because he holds that a simon in a public place is still a good simon. And I don't care if people walk on it, because simon also does have a simon. The owners won't give up hope, or he, even he trample on the simon still remains. But so what's my like then? Simon have a mail of that very point is a simon. A simon that you, that either the taste you didn't put it there, it fell on its own, or according to Rashi, it's very likely it fell on its own, even though you might have put it there. And that's the argument. That a common, a mail hole, simon mail of a simon. Bread with the coin side definitely fell on its own, or could have fallen on its own, it's not a simon. And if you hold, it's still a valid simon. That's exactly the argument, whether a simon comes themselves or a simon or not. That's how Rabbah learned. So Rabbah learned that everyone agrees with him that a simon in a public place is a good simon. How is Rabbah going to learn the next Mishnah, Kikr Balabais? So we already said before that food, nobody walks on. And Rabbah was going to learn that everybody holds that a simon that people trample on is not a good simon. It's not a good simon, but food is an exception. But what's the machlekes then by bread? We've got bread with money inside. But Rabbah, everyone knows that a simon that people trample on is not a simon. And the Eima bin Aleichem. But you don't walk on food. That's why the loaves of bread of Balabas is a valid simon in a public place, because people will not step close to it. Because if you do, whoever goes the first gets the first has to pick it up and find his own.
Those two go hand in hand. If you hold a certain simon,
no. Yeah, you do. You have no choice. Otherwise, how you learn kich? The only way to learn kich, yeah, you have no choice. And he'll say the same thing. They're arguing a simon that comes on its own. No, but if you learn that there is no simon of Shusha Rabbi, but by food there is a simon, because nobody's trampled on it. But again, he'll learn also the machlekes is whether simon of Bama Elov is a simon, not simon Rabbah. Tanagam is a lot of a simon, but who does have a simon? So by the end of the day, Rabbah and Rabbah both learned the machlekes of Rabbi Yehuda Meir is the same thing, a simon that came on its own, whether it's a valid simon or not. Igadamri, others say, another version is, we thought, Kuliam, everyone believes Simon Habam Elam have a Simon. We thought that everyone holds a valid Simon. What's the difference if you put it there, it came on its own, or it could have come on its own? And the Simon also does love a Simon. Everyone holds that a Simon that you trample on is not a valid Simon, like Rabbah. So there's another way of learning Rabbah. Everyone holds on a Kamara, Mayor, Behuda, all everyone agree that Simon in a public place is not a Simon that gets trampled on. And everyone holds that a Simon that comes on its own is a valid Simon. The question is, do people walk on food or not? And that's the machlekes of Yehuda Meir. My love, and Mavin Aleichem is arguing that this very point, if Mavin Aleichem, do people walk on food or not? So when we said before, Lema Ketanoi, that there's an argument tonight, we're not talking about the argument of Rabbah Rava, whether a simon gets trampled on or not, but arguing with this concept of people walking on food, stepping on food, or coming close to food. Is that so? That Mavin Aleichem? Or do we say that others say, yes, people walk on food as well? That itself is a machlekes. Ma'asov ma'avin, that people will walk on food, and therefore bread with a coin on it is not a simon, because simon also daughters is not a simon. Ma'asov ma'avin. That's the argument, whether ma'avin or not. Now, obviously, the way we're learning right now is we're following it up. That simon that people step on is not a valid simon. And Simon and Habam Elov is a Simon, but people Simon are only machlekes is whether Mavir Aleichem or not. So Rabbi Zvid said, name of Rava, it doesn't make sense. Same reason. Isagadat, that a Meir holds. Whoever holds that mavina loichlin, that you step on food, that's a bread with money, is not a good simon. So why bread of a balabas is a good simon? What's the difference? People step on it, and people step on food, they trample on it, and they would destroy the simon. They would crush the bread. Nobody can recognize anymore where it came from. And it, so my why? So if I made a whole simon, so have a simon, that trample simon is not a simon. No, mavina, let me walk on food. So tell me, kikish balabas is rabbi, my machis, the loaves of bread of balabas is rabbi, why do you announce it? The people step on it, and people step on food. So the same thing as before the Gemara, we just restarted with a different approach. So Rabbi said, "Name it over." No, I'm going to say that everyone agrees with me. Kuli alma, so Rabbi Shimon also does have a simon. Everyone agrees that a simon in a public place is still a valid simon, and mavir aleichlin, and people walk on food. Who cares? It's still a good simon. So what's my question? Made of Yehuda. Like we said before, the argument is whether simon habom me'elu simon or not. So in this version here, we thought that the argument of Yehuda made is whether people walk, trample on food or not. So the first version, we thought the argument of Rav Meir Yehuda is this very point: if a simon gets trampled on, is it a valid simon or not? And now we're saying that the original temple said they're arguing on whether people step on food or they don't step on food. But the conclusion is the same. No, they're arguing about simon habam me'elub. So the comments of a simon be'elub, lo habi simon, therefore bread with a coin inside is not a simon, if you don't have a simon. Rabba tells you, kuliyam b'simon rosa dars, lo habi simon. And Rabbi also is not happy because he wants to learn that everyone agrees with him that a simon also does not a simon, and therefore, and so how come by kikush of balabayis we say that you give it back? Must be because people don't step on food. No, if you don't step on food, so what about bread with the coin inside? They're arguing about simon b'me'ela. Tanakam asof yibalev lo have a simon yosar have a simon. Amen. Azir meshen the Rabbi. Now, Rav Zitz says something else in the name of Rav. What's the language you have to hear from the owner when you say, ah, he definitely abandoned hope of ever recovering it? Kivin the Amr, he says, violent of Saran Kis. He says, oi, terrible. I just had a big loss, suffered a big loss. That's me, actually. That's clear that he's abandoning hope of ever recovering it. The Amr Azim Mashayn the Rav, Hilchus Allah is, Kirichay Beshus Rabim, Hare Elu Shaloi. Bundles.
Who's the person here? It's the guy who found it. So he's sitting behind him and he hears him saying this.
No, one, if you found it first, you have to should be passing like a buyer years or
you're saying this, then you walked out.
Exactly. Or they start looking for it. So here's a kriches bishus rabbi, mahare eilu shaloi, they belong to you. Bishus a yachid. What about in the bishus a yachid? They found these bundles. It depends. Before we took it, made it clear. Rabbi, either because it gets pushed around, where it is, or and where you learn before, there's no simon. According to Rabbi, even if there's a simon, it gets trampled on, you can keep it. But it's just the yachid, it depends. What does it depend on? And even if there's no simon, makom is a simon. If it fell down, hadi elu shaloi, you can keep it. Why? We're talking about when there's a. Remember, Rava learns there's no simon here. If there's no simon, what's the simon according to Rava? Makom. But if it fell down, how in the world is the guy going to tell you the makom? How does he know where it fell down? He has no idea. Hadi shaloi. Then you can keep it because there's no simon at all. Ederech hanoch, if it's clear, visible that it was placed there, even though it has no simon, you know the person remembers because he put it down. He's probably going to come back. Noitul machle. If you take it, you got to go and announce it. Remember, there's no simon. If there's a simon, there's a simon, it's amazing. Rabbi has an argument with the teacher and he makes a ruling, the rule of like me. Very seldom you find that the person who's involved in the argument decides that the halacha is like himself. Because this is Rabbi's argument to Rabbi, whether Mokim is a simon or whether a simon also does have a simon or not. And he said, the halacha is like me, that simon does. He's still a good simon. Very, very odd. Anyway, next one. Talking about it, it's a Mishnah, but you think you're traveling to the Mishnah, you have a bundle of fish, we say that you can keep it. Now, why can you keep it? First of all, it's tied on a string. Am I the heavy cash of simon? Why can't the knot itself be a simon? The Gemara says, and we had this right in the beginning, but the knot itself should be a simon. Says the Gemara, the kit to the side, we're talking about a knot that all the people who generally go out and trap bird all have the same knot, so there's no simon. Everyone does the same kind of thing. Count how many fish are on, ask people, so how many fish are on there, and then that's the simon. Even yam the shaman, like eggs, you sell by the dozen, everyone puts the same amount of fish on the string. Minyan have a siman or lavasim. Generally speaking, is a number considered a siman or not? Omer Rav Sheshet to Nisu, we learned. Matikli kesel echoshe. If you found, let's say, a utensil made out of silver, made out of copper, or gist and shaleva, but you found kelim of lead, you know, shards, pieces. The whole kli matzitz or metal, how they do lo yachze, don't give it back. Actually, yitin ois, unless he gives you some kind of a siman that it's theirs. Or he can tell you how much the silver weighs, how much silver is there, how much copper is there, because they're precious. Now you tell me weight is a simon. Once you tell me that these things, which is an intrinsic part of the thing, it's not like normally we interpret a simon as you made a special kind of a sign to show that it's yours here. It's just this is the item itself. And yet you tell me the weight of the item is a simon. So too the number of the items, and so too the measure of the items should also be a siman. And Tosha says in certain things, everything plays in merit. Certain things where it's more common to weigh something, then the measurement is a greater siman. And where it's more common to look at measure, then the weight is a greater siman. Is a greater siman.
For example, making parts and things that each one weigh different today.
You're right. So fair, exactly. Takes over, for example, on a garment. On a garment, usually it goes by measure. Nobody weighs it. So how much, you know, cotton is in the garment. So if a guy gives you a siman in weight, their weight instead of siman. And let's say you buy fruits by the kilo, by the weight, and then a guy tells you how many apples are in the bag, then that would be expensive. If you have two people, each one gives you a different thing, which one is a stronger siman. Setting one further. Piece of meat. We say that you can keep it. Why can't the weight be a siman? Everybody buys, you know, 500 grams of this thing, a pound of this thing. But what about the cut itself? Which part of the animal is it? Is it a flanken? Is this, you know, where is it? Is it a chicken? Where is it? For example, either dafka, either is it near the neck, or is it the leg? You found strips of fish, of a dog noshach or a fish that was bitten. So we see that a cut of fish is a siman. Barrels of wine and oil and true and grain, and dry figs and olives, all these you can keep. So all these barrels, see more later what this is talking about. But what is even mechaticha is dogging. Cuts of fish, you know, let's say the part of the fish. We're talking. So right now we think the fish itself has no siman, and the siman is a cut. Is it near the head, near the tail? And not the style of the cut, but which part of the fish you found? Was it no? How come I skin? But ikasimana the piska. The cut itself is done in a very unique way, and that's the siman, the cut, not where in the fish it is, because you can guess. Now here, because we were able to put him. So we have here. He was the first one who made a lozakanasi. He made a hamatash, but he did it out of meat. Or maybe a cripple. Look at the picture of Rashi here, triangle. They can it says, Dunya the dog noshu. The example we say, a cut of a fish, and then we say a fish that was bitten into. Now that's a siman, because how many fish are bitten into? You can see the teeth marks. Shmami no, so it's talking about a unique cut. So you know what? Now Taisa says here an interesting thing here. We talk about, we're going to have an Avodah Zarah, the concept that the basar shenis ala min ha'ayin. If let's say you have meat, kosher, everything else, but nobody was watching it, there could be a guy got to it and exchange it, you're not allowed to eat. You have to have a sign, a chaysim, but a chaysim. In fact, we have the thing called chavis, which is, you know, chol of milk and basar, beis, basar, and yayin, and tafet chelis. These four things you have to actually mind. What do you call it? So we luchayde, you need a double simon, not just one simon. And here we just have one simon, a cut. So the Bay and Tom says an aging thing. We are more of a fascinating thing. And this is a debate that you have. What's better to have in your house? A maid who's a yid totally fry, who runs the house, or a guy? You would think a yid is always better. Says the Bay and Tom, a yid who doesn't care about, let's say, kashrus, is far more suspect than a guy. Farmers are, and the reason is because the Yid who does not in conscious thinks he knows everything and doesn't care. A guy doesn't know, so they'll ask and they'll And they're more confident. A Yid is much more confident that they can do whatever they want because they think they know what they're doing. they could cause you more problems, which happened by us a few times, than a goy. They will always ask. Interesting idea of Rabbi Tam. Not more agreed with Rabbi Tam. Okay, so back to the Gemara. And that's traces that lots of kinds. The Gemara writes, "Oh my, you just said before, chavish shall yain powers of wine, shall shemen and oil, shall tvu and grain, shall garegere, shall zaytim, and shall all that need to keep." I but now we learned, we will learn in a Mishnah later on where it says, "Kade yain, the kade shemen, barrels of wine, barrels of oils, chayiv lahachis." When do we say that a barrel of wine or oil, you have to make an announcement? When do you say you don't have to make an announcement? Amarab, masnisin berushim. The Mishnah is talking about where it says you have to make the announcement. It's talking about berushim. Rushim is that people will come and buy the barrels of wine. Let's say buy 15, 20 barrels of wine. It's a certain season of the year. Rashi says usually it's Shvat or Nissan. That the people, you know, sell large amounts of wine to wholesalers and so on. And when you're buying 10 or 15 barrels, you want to taste the wine before you buy each barrel. So you open the seal and you taste each wine. Then you reseal it. And so most of the barrels before you do that are open. And now you came along and you sealed it. And that's the simon. So being machleik is the Rishonim. Rashi learns that the very fact that it was sealed, that's the simon. Because a lot of barrels are not sealed. In that case, and if it's not sealed, that also should be a simon. But nobody says if you say, oh, it wasn't sealed. The way Rashi learns, that's what the Shem asks Rashi. So other Shem say it's the seal itself. Every person had their own identifying seal. The way they made it, you can go, this is a Reuben seal, this is a Shimon seal, and so on. So that's the Simon. So the Gemara, okay, so the Mishnah is talking about there was a seal. Mikhlal the Baraisa, and the Baraisa said that you can keep the barrels. Must be talking about, but there's no seal. The Pesuach. Ibe Pesuach, if you didn't seal it, I mean, right now we understood you don't even cover it. You don't cover it, means it's open to snakes and everything else. Open to other extraneous different creatures that can ruin the whole wine. I mean, you don't care about it. It's Aveda Medas. It should be Hefker. It should be Hefker completely. So the Gemara of Rav Hesha ben Meitzi. Rav Hesha said, so even though it says that Eilu Shaloi, as if because there's no Simon, but Ruchel is much more than that. It's Aveda Medas. It's like Hefker. No, we're talking about ben Meitzi. It's floating on top. In other words, there's a lid there. Just he didn't seal it. So there's no Simon. How are you going to identify? By the barrel, barrels are uniform, and Bashenka, if you seal it, the seal itself, which Kaiser learns, is the simon. Abaye says, I feel to me, Rosh, I can say the Braisa and the Mishnah both told me there was a seal. No, so how can the Braisa even keep it? If it's the time before Shvatnis and before they go ahead and everybody tasted the barrels, only a few people come in early, then, and so then it's a simon. Now, wait, Rosh. It's not as much easier to understand. In other words, before this and before Shvat, no one, but before you sold the barrels, you don't seal it because you want people to taste the wine and buy it. So if a guy comes along and says, look, you found it in the month of Cheshvan, but it's sealed, the seal itself, the fact that it's sealed, that in itself is simon. According to Taisa, that every seal has its own identifying mark. What's the difference if it's the season that everybody opened or if it's or nobody opened? It's your seal. Unless the seal was not such a unique thing. So if only a few people will say that, okay, you can tie it that this is my seal. When everybody goes along and makes seals, it's quite likely that a number of people have very similar seals, so it's no longer the seal itself is no longer a seal. Once he found a barrel of wine. Rabbi Yaakov found a barrel of wine after the eitzes were opened up, wide open, and he wanted to know whether he can keep it or not. Also, the kamid abayin. He came before this very abayin. Of course, the abayin, you can keep it regardless if there's a seal on there. Not. I'm like, you're not to keep it. Boy, so Bibi has a question. Mokum have a simon, Allah have a simon. This argument is happening around the rubber about Mokum. He asked him, is the where you found the barrel, is that considered a simon or not? Omale Tinesua, we learned. Motzah Chavishayan Shasham Shatu is a regular day. Somebody's going to keep it. Now, Isaac, that's a Mokum simon. Tell me that Mokum is a simon. The Lichin Mokum, okay, the barrel itself might not have a simon, but why don't you say, I found a barrel of wine, and let the guy come over and say, where you found it? Or let or announce, I found it in this place. What do you think I found? You're talking about here that this is right where on the porch, where everybody brings the imports their wine or exports their wine, and that's where they place all the barrels, the hundreds of barrels there. So therefore, that's how can you make mokum simon when there's so many other barrels at the same time? My time, why Taka isn't the simon? Because I mean, we say just like okay, you might have left a barrel there. You know, you've loaded the container and you forgot a barrel. Because everyone's there. How do you know it's yours? Just because you say this place, it could just as well have been somebody else's. Why is Mokum not a Simon? Damri, let me say. Why is Mokum not a Simon? There you said, why is Raksa the Nara not a Simon? What do you call it? And now the second version is, even if you were very specific, you didn't just say Raksa the Nara, oh, somewhere near the port or near the river bank. You say exactly where it was. Mokum, exactly where it is. Nevertheless, I was simming. Because that's the area generally where everybody has their barrels of wine before the import export, could just as well have been somebody else. Who gave the person, the Ashka Kufra, there was a person that found, what do you call it? He found the thing, tar, bimatsarta, on the place where they press olives, also came from. He found the barrel there. You know, they use tar to close it up. So you want to know whether they can keep it or not. You can keep it because there's no simon, and Mokin has not a simon as well. He saw that the guy wasn't happy with the place. He felt uncomfortable. He felt that he should maybe try to find who the owner is. So he told him, you think I'm just being makel? Go with my son, split half and half, because I'm perfectly happy that you can keep it. Rav hold a mokum is not a sinner, because Lachayi says he can keep it. Or Rav Shem Yish by the Nogaba, the Chazer the Kotcha bechalfi. No, mokum might be a sinner. You know why in this case mokum wasn't a sinner? Because he saw that it aged, and he saw that it's been there for a long time. Definitely the owner is going to be seems to grow with all kind of growth on it. Now Shem Elazar said, "Now Mishnah that kli and purya, you don't have to announce. What in the world is kli and purya?" Saying what my and purya, I'm going kalim chadoshim shloisavos naim. We're talking about brand new kalim that you did not satisfy your eyes. In other words, there's a thing called tviyas ayin. You have a look and you know exactly what it is. Savos ayin is much more than tviyas ayin. You have to have it for a long time so you really became familiar with this particular item. And ampuri is ein poi raya. Can't bring a proof of it because you didn't have it long enough to say, oh, I'm familiar with my kalim. Hey, what are we talking about? I is behu simin. If there is a simin, then kiloi savos ayin ma'av. Who cares if you satisfy your eyes? You knew it for a long time or you didn't know it for a long time. Who cares? And either lesbo simon, there's no simon, is kisavasan I mahabe. Even if you are if you saw it for a long time and you satisfy your eye, who cares? So it was a loyalum to lesbo simon. There's no simon. Nafkamina lahadura litzurba mirabon. Betvias ena. The question is, according to Shimon Loza, Tvias ayin is not good enough. I need savasan ayin. I told you yesterday, last time the musician Magid shot Tvias ayin, that you knew that these are your nutsutsas. This is the work you have to do. So then you don't need savasan ayin. Tvias ayin is good enough because outside you can see straight away. Rav Shimon Loza says you need savasan ayin. You need much more than just Tvias ayin having a look. You need to be satisfied. You got to know you've had it for a while, so you're familiar.
I feel like a hat.
It's your hat. Many times you put your hat down the shul, and then this is an older hat, and then you see four other hats that look the same. So what's my kim luba gavayu umadin? Let me get back to him. But if he wasn't, didn't know it long enough, you don't give it back to him. And who do you give it back to? Only a tzuba merabbanon, because we literally last time that we don't give it back to Amoritz because either they don't have recognition or because of the Shayim say we don't trust them. So the idea of Talmud Chacham is only because we trust them. And why do we trust the Talmud Chacham? What's the criteria of that? We'll see tomorrow night in Mitzvah.